Welcome to the Cognitive Psychology, Learning and Memory lesson on Language Acquisition. By the end of the video, you will learn about Language and Cognition, Linguistics, Language Acquisition, Language and Thought and Theories of Language Acquisition. You will also learn about the structure of language and the biology of language acquisition. Cognitive psychologists see language as a complex system that uses sounds and symbols to communicate thoughts. Language is more than just talking, it shapes how we think and see the world. This link between language and thinking is key because it affects how we understand and interact with everything around us. Linguistics helps us understand language by breaking it down into phonetics, morphology, and syntax. Phonetics is about the sounds of language, morphology is about the form of words, and syntax is about how words are arranged to make sentences. Together, these parts create the complex structure of human language that we use to communicate. Language acquisition in children starts with babbling and moves to forming full sentences. At first, babies make simple sounds. Over time, these sounds turn into words and then complex sentences. This growth reflects the child's thinking skills and their interactions with others. It's a mix of biological and social development. Skinner's behaviorism theory says that language learning is based on imitation and reinforcement. Kids copy sounds and words they hear from adults. When they say something right, they get positive feedback, which makes them keep using those words. This theory shows how important practice and positive feedback are in learning language. Chomsky's innateness theory changed our view of language learning. He said kids are born with an ability to learn language thanks to something called the language acquisition device, LAD. This helps them understand and use language without formal teaching. It shows that language ability is part of our biology. Piaget's cognitive theory links language learning with overall intellectual development. He said that a child's ability to learn language depends on their thinking skills. As kids grow and their thinking develops, so does their ability to learn language. This theory shows that intellectual and language growth go hand in hand. Biological aspects of language acquisition focus on how the brain develops to support language skills. The brain changes a lot during early childhood, making it better at processing and producing language. This includes forming new connections between neurons and improving pathways for language information. Neural network models give us new ideas about how language learning works. These models, which mimic the brain, learn to recognize and produce language patterns by being exposed to a lot of language data. This suggests that our brain gets better at language by constantly adapting to the language we hear. Integrationist theories, like Bruner's Language Acquisition Support System, LAS, highlight the role of social interaction in language learning. These theories say that kids learn language by engaging with caregivers who help them use language. This shows that language learning is both a cognitive and social process. Each theory gives us useful insights but also has its own challenges. For example, behaviorism might ignore the internal thought processes, while innateness might downplay the role of the environment. Cognitive theories focus on mental development but may overlook the social aspects. Understanding these theories together gives us a complete view of how language develops, showing the interplay between biology, thinking, and the environment. And with that, we wrap up this informative lesson. For additional information on this lesson, please look at the content below the video in the online course. To get a list of the important questions and their answers for this lesson, please refer to the guidebook by our publications provided to you with this course for free. It shows you a list of all the questions that have the highest chance of coming in your next exams based on research carried out on previous year question papers. All the best, and I'll see you in the next lesson.